Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Now that you know how Vertex form is set up and how to graph it, you're fully prepared to use quadratic functions in Vertex form to solve real-world scenarios. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to answer questions about real-world scenarios represented by quadratic functions in Vertex form. First, we'll discuss the three main features that are usually the most important when dealing with quadratic functions. Then we'll work on some examples together. If you feel confident, I encourage you to pause each example and work it out on your own before I give you the answer. In most scenarios involving quadratics, there are three features you're likely interested in: the max, or the min, which is always the vertex, a time when the output is zero, which are the roots, or an initial value, which is the y-intercept. In this video, you're going to learn how to identify and calculate all three of these using vertex form. Some problems, like this one, are easy to answer when the quadratic is in vertex form. The function f of x equals negative 2 x minus 1 squared plus 2 represents the height of a ball in yards x seconds after it's thrown in the air. What is its maximum height? So the fact that we're being asked for a minimum or a maximum is a major hint that we just need the vertex. And since the function is in vertex form, we barely have to do any math. We could just pull the vertex right out of the function. If x is seconds and y is the height in yards, then this vertex says that the maximum occurs 1 second after throwing the ball when it's 2 yards high. So the maximum height is 2 yards. We could get the same answer from graphing this function. The maximum height is at 2 yards, 1 second after throwing the ball. The function f of x equals negative x minus 10 squared plus 81 represents a souvenir shop's profits from shirt sales based on a shirt's price, x. At what prices will the revenue break even with manufacturing costs? This time, we want to know when the revenue breaks even with manufacturing costs. Revenue is the money they make from sales, and manufacturing costs are how much they pay to get the shirts. So for those to break even means the shop makes no profit. If we're asking when is the profit zero, that's the same as asking what are the roots. So if we set this function equal to zero, we'll find the answer. When solving this, remember we can't do anything about that square until everything outside of it is gone. So first, we need to subtract 81 from both sides. Then we can divide that coefficient of negative 1 off the square, effectively removing the negatives from both sides. Now that the square is isolated, we can cancel it out using a square root. Remember, whenever you take the square root of a positive number, you get 2 results, effectively splitting the equation into 2. If we get negative 9, then when we add 10, we get 1. And if it's positive 9, then we add 10 and get 19. Now we know that there are 2 roots, 1 and 19. And remember, these are prices for the shirts. At $1, the shop will probably sell lots of shirts, but for way too cheap. And at $19, they probably won't sell enough. Again, we can also see these same results on a graph. If you want some bonus points, what price should they sell the shirts for to make the most profit? The last thing we might be asked for is the initial value, like in this problem. The function f of x equals 1/2 times x minus 6 squared minus 14 represents a diver's height above the pool x seconds after her jump. How high was the diving board? This time we're being asked how high the diving board from which she dove was. In other words, what's the diver's height right when she starts her dive? If the function measures her height while diving, then her dive would start at 0 seconds. So all we have to do is input 0 and see what the output is. 0 minus 6 is negative 6, and negative 6 squared is 36. Multiply that by 1/2 to get 18, and 18 minus 14 is 4. So 0 seconds into the dive, meaning before the dive actually happened, the diver was standing on a 4-foot high diving board. If we graph the function, we also see that she started 4 feet high. Then she dove under the water and came back up. A word of warning here. Be careful of scenarios with no answer. If a problem gives you a function with a positive coefficient and asks for a maximum, there isn't one. There's only a minimum. Same thing goes with minimums of functions with negative coefficients. No minimum, just a maximum. And some parabolas never touch the x-axis, so a question about its roots won't have any answer. On the plus side, every parabola has a y-intercept. You might just have to zoom out pretty far to see it. In the next lesson, you're going to learn how to solve problems using standard form. I know you already know what standard form is, but we've waited until now to solve in standard form because it takes a lot more complicated math than factored form or vertex form. Think of it this way. You're almost to the end of Algebra 1. And if you've made it this far, you can take any complicated math I throw at you. See you next time.